Hey guys, welcome to Mishi Blue Tarot. I am back for all of you with another reading today. Alright, so today we are going to be looking at what does your person want to say to you right now. Alright, so I'll be using my own channel deck plus variety of decks. I've already picked two oracle cards just to see the core theme of what your person could be feeling or would want to say to you at this point. Alright, so let's begin. You can see I have three piles here laid out for you. Number one is the Malachite bracelet, and I've used these bracelets today. Number two is the Labradorite bracelet. And pile three is the Rose Quartz bracelet. Okay. So, timestamps will be there in the description box. You can pause the video, meditate over your situation, think about your person, and go ahead and pick the pile that is attracting you the most. Alright? I'll pause for like 2-3 seconds. We begin with the Malachite. Alright, so people who chose pile number one, let's see what does your person want to say to you right now. Okay, or just in, like whenever. This is something that they want to tell you. And these are two oracle cards that I have picked up, and then I'll be using my channel deck and other tarot decks as well. So here's the Malachite bracelet, whoever chose this. Great gratitude. One ring circus. Alright. So pile number one. Your person could be in a very tough situation in their life, okay? And they are very thankful about your presence, although could be that they are not telling you what they are going through inside. You like that sort of a person who, or your presence basically makes this person feel that, okay, I have something to look forward to. Because they're stuck in some sort of a situation. Okay, this one ring circus card is giving me that vibe. One second. They're stuck. And they have to be there for some reason. Let me see. The other thing that I see here is that your person could be right now a little overwhelmed also. Could be any reason, alright? I'm seeing they could be overwhelmed because they are scared that, you know, you crack them open. And this person doesn't want to be like that. Or maybe he's not ready to be open and vulnerable. So, more than trust issues, I think, of course, they trust you, they know that you are a better person, you are pretty stable, okay? But still, I'm seeing that this person wants to be at a distance. However, the point, and this is emotional distance, because you see water around this card. So, this is emotional distance majorly, but I'm seeing that this person is not going to let you go. Because they know your value. They really value you. It's about gratitude here. They value you a lot and you're on their mind. and you both kind of want each other in each other's lives. However, like even if this person is a little aloof or is not giving as much as you want, you're not being very demanding with this person, however, because somewhere I feel that you sense it, that this person could be having some issues. And that is why I'm seeing that this person is not willing to let you go. Alright? So let's see some cards from here. From my deck. What do they want to say to you? It still haunts me. Okay. Maybe this person has a past and that is the reason why they are like this, like keeping a distance, or maybe in the past they made some mistake and they're afraid to let go of that experience because it is still fresh in their mind. You make me feel alive. Yeah. And that's the reason why this person doesn't want to let you go, because you have a very soothing demeanor for this person and they feel very captivated by your personality. That's what I'm getting, okay? And you could be very intuitive, very soft-hearted and stuff. So this person likes that thing about you. Okay, I love you and I do care about you. Alright, so this person doesn't want to let you go at all. And as I told you that this person has pretty strong feelings for you. Pretty strong. And that's the reason. Maybe they're not showing it. This I think they're not, because as I said, we started on that note that there is a tough situation, they're scared to open up, but at the same time they have a lot of feelings for you. Okay, let's see a couple of tarot cards to kind of see what is going on with them. Do they want to say to you at this point? The sun. Yes, I told you they feel very happy with you, and the moments that they spend with you, they feel very connected with you. Very connected, because somehow, for a lot of you, I'm picking up that you could be a healer or a spiritual person in nature, just in general. And that is very attractive about you. Like, you have a certain glow on your face because of spirituality, because of the kind of spiritual person that you are. What else do they want to say to you? I'm seeing that this person really gets some divine downloads whenever they are around you. But somehow they're not kind of... They're in a... You know, one foot in a yes, one foot in no. And they're kind of like struggling in between. Okay, let's see. Queen of Cups, yes. So they are... Sorry for the jerk, guys. They are very emotional about you. And they know that so are you. You are also the sort of person who is very emotional and intuitive. Because both, I as I said, that you know, I picked up that you could be a healer. Somebody who is very spiritual, and this thing is admired by this person. And that's what they want to say to you at this point. Alright, let me see what else. The Lover, yes. So you both could be very different from each other, but it's like you both keep coming back from each other because of the divine bond that exists. really are able to kind of strike the right chords in this person. King of Pentacles. And they want to give you something stable. They want to give you something stable, but we've already seen that they are not in the position to give it right now because of their own situation. Let's see, what else? The High Priestess. So yes, I think this person is staying silent about what they feel so much, whatever feelings that they have, because I think they don't have a plan in mind. They don't have a plan to proceed exactly over here. That's what I'm seeing. Let's see what else do they want to say to you. But however, I think this person really admires you, is grateful. All of those energies I can see here. Let's see what else. The Waiting Game. So yes, this calls for some sort of waiting, and this person also wants you to wait for them. Maybe at present they cannot open up because of their own situation. This is nothing to do with you. It's not like they don't love you or don't care about you. But it's in general that the kind of tight spot that they are in. Okay? Can we take it slow? So yes, this person wants you around. Okay? But again, the problem I told you. Okay? That there is a little bit of waiting here before this person opens up completely. Because I see that there is a desire from their side to give you something very stable and something very nice, okay? Let's see what else. This is beautiful. So this connection for them is very beautiful. And that's the reason why they don't want to lose it. As I told you right in the beginning. What else from the tarot cards? What else do they want to say to you? The Empress. They look at you in a very different light altogether. Pile number one. I mean, it's beautiful. It's just beautiful. The way you conduct yourself. The kind of care you have. I think this is... It's not only about them. It's in general about others. Like the way you feel things. The way you care about everything. And make sure that everything around is okay. Alright, it just kind of makes them feel very happy from within. And the Emperor, so this person feels that you both are divine counterparts. So you are about, I mean, genders don't matter, forget it. Like, I mean, one is about basically the divine masculine and feminine energies. Like, one is about receptivity, one is about acceptance, one is about softness, the other one is about determination and a balance of both, okay? And this person really, really wants you to be the way you are. That's what they want to say to you. Five of Pentacles. So maybe in the past, I think this person has lost something, or they are fearful of losing you as well. They could have lost something in the past and it still bothers them. What else do they want to say to you? Six of Wands. But however, I think this person really wants to win this. Yeah. They want to win this and move to a zone of something more calmer with you. And that's what they want to say to you. Alright, I'll pick up an advice for you. What should you do in this situation? Because I like to end the readings with a small advice. So let's see. What should you do here? by the book, poised. This connection has the potential of becoming something very stable. But before that, some mending work has to happen. That is happening. And it will come to you very soon. This door will open very soon. I'm seeing that, you know, when I say buy the book, it is basically telling me that I think you want things to be like usual, okay? So for them to give you this usual thing, they have to be in that state of affairs, in that state of mind, so that they can do it, basically. Alright? And it's happening. It's happening slowly and gradually. This person is also opening up slowly. As I said, that they are a little caught. Maybe they have boundaries at this point. But it doesn't mean that they want to let you go. Okay? They have boundaries because of their own issues that they've been facing in their life or they had faced in their life. Okay? Nothing else, nothing to do with you as a person. Alright? Okay, so that is what I have for you, pile number one. You can follow me on Instagram. It's Nishi Blue Tarot Official. I do daily energy check-ins over there just in case if you are interested. So let me know in the comments if this resonated with you. I shall see you soon again. Take care. Bye. Okay, so let's move to pile number two. Whoever chose this labradorite bracelet, this is my bracelet actually. Alright, okay, so I have picked up two oracle cards and I'll be using my channel deck and I'm going to be picking up tarot cards as well to see what is it. Alright, so let's see from here. Rock bottom, commitment. Wow. Okay, your relationship with your person has come to a point where it is about the commitment. I think your person wants to commit to you. This looks to me like a contract or I don't know what, but it's just giving me a speechless kind of a feeling at this point when I read cards for you, pile number two. I think you guys had been distant and you were walking this path, but now it's reached a point where I think both of you are quite clear that this is it. And the masculine in this connection is more clear than the feminine here. It's an event and this will happen, I guess. I'm sorry, pile number two. I have a very speechless kind of a feeling. I don't know, people who are watching this are speechless, or I don't know, maybe your person is speechless. You're trying to tap into their energy, so I think this person is speechless. Or could be that they're not saying this to you, but they want this. they want this to do. Let's see what else they want to say. I'll use my channel lit. We know, like, are they getting there? We'll check other cards to see, are they getting there? Or is it like they're very sure that they want this to do? I love you. All right. Am I the only one in your life? Jealousy. I think about you a lot. Okay. I'll pick one more message. The regret is huge. Alright. This person definitely wants you in their life in a committed format. I mean, I'm using the word format because this man seems to be a very, very, data-driven, I don't know, very business-suity kind of a thing. So that's why I'm saying that this person wants you in a particular way in their life, and they want to make sure that they are the only one, only man or the only woman in your life. Okay, they love you. It's reached that point. They have feelings. It's reached that point, and this person thinks a lot about you. There is a regret. Also, we see through the tarot cards, there could be some sort of a, probably in the past, because this is regret. So maybe in the past, they did something which they did not like or they don't like. Okay. But they regret it. Maybe maybe the way they spoke to you, or maybe whatever they said was a little regretful. I mean, and at this point, they regret it. That's what it is. Like, they wish they could undo it. Okay? Let me see, what do I have from the tarot cards. But definitely, this person wants to be the only one in your life. Let's see, what else do they want to say to you? Page of Cups. So this is also a lot about thinking. They think a lot about you, and it just takes them to another dimension. That's what I'm seeing. They start flying and all. But there is they feel kiddish also with you. It's a very beautiful feeling is what I see. The Hierophant. And they're able to see the horizon. Like, somehow they're able to see the light at the end of the tunnel, because you're around. And I'm seeing that this person wants something stable, definitely, with you. Three of Pentacles. They want to work on this. I'm also seeing that there could be a third person also involved here, maybe from your side or from their side, I don't know. But they want to still fix it. And I mean, irrespective of whatever exists, the extras, they still want you. And they want to work on it to clear that also, is what I'm getting. Okay? And the Star. So yes. I think, guys, today's Instagram reading might just go with you. You can follow me. It's Mishidu Tarot Official. You can check that out. I'm seeing that this person wishes to be with you. Very strongly, I'm seeing that this person wants you in their life. And there is this wish that they have, so that they could just be with you. And it's like they probably sometimes think that, okay, it's a little too much to ask. But they want this. you on this video. Let's see what else. This love is crazy. Okay, listen. While I shuffle, I know there's something about this pile. I don't know what your person is up to. It's scary. It's the feeling is very overwhelming. Like I don't know how to express this. And maybe your person is feeling overwhelmed because of this connection that they have with you. This love that they feel for you is very crazy. Let's see what else. I need some time. See, yes, they might just withdraw sometimes. But this is not a permanent withdrawal. Maybe for 2-3 days they might not talk to you. But let's see. It's overwhelming for them. So I have 2-3 cards here. I am going to take these. I always want to know what's going on with you. I can't break this connection. Life partner. I never wanted to hurt you. Something happened between the two of you. I want to meet you. This person seems to be absolutely ready at this point. To give you something. You know that feeling when you reach, alright, there's no going back from here, I want her or him. This is it. Like, that sort of a feeling is what I get from here. Okay? If this person had hurt you in the past, they want to fix it. And this person could also be thinking to say goodbye to something and take a decision, a yes or a no. This person is contemplating now. Married, but you're hitting them like anything, like I mean your thoughts or your, so it's that feel. Oh god, why am I feeling speechless? Okay, so I'm seeing that this person is in this feeling that I mean, how do I resist it anymore? Like, I mean, it's everything right here. Okay, that's the vibe that I get over here. It is a new beginning. The Fool. But the point is, somewhere I feel this person is a little scared about how you are going to react to this. Yes. They are somewhere a little bit fearful of rejection. Little bit, okay? Now, I don't know why, but that's why we see that, you know, am I the only one in your life and all of these things. So a little bit of fear of rejection, but pretty much this person is ready. Yeah, so that's what I see. Pile number two, I'll pick up an advice for you over here in this situation, because I usually end readings with that. What's the advice for you here? Why? Blessed. Co-create. I think you have been in a zone of a lot of question answer about this connection, that can this happen? I think even you have a little bit of trust issues with this person. Can this happen? Will this happen? Is this like, just saying that, alright guys, I am just speechless for pile number two. I don't know why. Maybe a person's thoughts are like at this point very overwhelming, and it's very, I'm having to think it, I'm so sorry. But advice to you here is to accept this thing, because it's like a blessing, and I have a feeling that you guys will have some babies or something with co-create. That's what I'm seeing. There is something that you both are doing together, and there's something that can happen together. Okay, so don't hesitate, because this feeling is beautiful. The emotions associated with this is beautiful. You're finally getting the answers to certain things, and it's a divinely guided answer, by the way. Look at this book having angel wings. So if you had some questions in your mind that why did this happen, it's a blessing. Both these, oh my god, oh, okay. 4, 4 and 4. 3 plus 1, 4. 2 plus 2, 4. And then again, 4. Stability, stability, guys. The pile number 2, it happened for your stability. If you keep questioning, why did this happen? This connection is to bring in the stability that you always wanted in your life. Alright? Just long story short. What a reading. Pile number 2, your person's overwhelmed me. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. Let me know in the comments if this resonated. Also, private readings are open, so you can reach out to me. And you can follow me on Instagram, as I said, if you like daily three card readings or something. I do daily energy check-ins over there. Take care. I shall see you soon again. Bye. Alright, so let's move to the final pile, the rose quartz. Let's see, what does your person want to say to you at this point? Alright, pile number 2 just overwhelmed me. So let me just take a sip of water and then start. Alright, pile number 2, the rose quartz. Let's see, what does your person want to say to you at this point? Metamorphosis, the sacred temple, spirit. All right. All right, pile number 3, your person is going through a huge transformation, all right, and your connection is protected by spirit. So whatever path you are on with this person, like, I don't know what part of your journey are you at with this person, because I can see that ups and downs could be a lot of things, but still, whatever you went through in this connection, be it ups and downs, be it things not working out, be it just in general that you know, you felt very complicated with this person, all of those energies, it's all a part of the process. So trust the process, and this person is trusting the process too, and because of this process, I see this person opening up as well. And the thing is that this connection that the two of you have, and what your person wants to tell you also, is that you both are on a spiritual journey with each other. Trust me, the kind of changes that the two of you could be bringing, and I'm sure that your person is feeling it right now because of this push to change something or to change themselves, okay? And that's what they want to say to you, that they understand the reality of this connection. They know how spiritually connected this connection is. They know it. Alright? Let's see, what else do they want to say to you? This can lead to something bigger. Yes, and they are aware of it, as I said, that they feel it too. Is this practical? So yes, I see that this person could be questioning sometimes, but they feel a very strong connection with you. Very, very strong connection with you. I need some time, probably, because to understand if this is practical, and I'm charmed every time I see you. So this person, okay, doesn't want to let you go. They want you in their life, but they are in the zone of acceptance. They're in the zone of understanding things even more deeply about this connection, which could have been absent in the past. Okay, maybe they were not sure, maybe they were not confident to do this in the past, but now they are becoming confident. I can see this. Alright, let's pick up some tarot cards to see what else do they want to say to you. Person is clear about and is sure that they want to have you in their life. They want to hold on to you as a, like a treasure, which I see that they do consider you as a treasure. Wants to, if in their life, okay, I see that if they had some issues, if they still have a lot of responsibilities, they want to wrap up everything so that they can invest on this connection. That's what I pick up for you guys here. And in fact, you know what, you and your presence has healed this person in a lot of ways maybe you don't even know. Okay, this person feels a strong attachment with you, and it's like, I think the metamorphosis and Ten of Wands just tells me the same thing, that whatever responsibilities or whatever situation was stopping this person from coming towards you, I think they want to wrap that up. The word is wrap up, okay? Because that could be something that was stopping them from coming to you, okay? With the Magician, I feel that yes, they are prepared to do this. Basically prepared to kind of fix things. Let's see what else. What else do they want to say to you? It still haunts me. I want to travel with you, okay? That's like basically they want to spend more and more time with you. And it still haunts me. Now, I don't know if they have a past which was very, very concerning, because Ten of Wands is there. So I don't know, like, I mean, if they made a mistake in the past, which is something that they have to bear with till now. I want to meet you. Yes, I told you, spend time meeting you. They want to do all of this so that they get to know you more and more. I am trying. So yes, as I said, that they are trying to wrap those things up and come to you, be with you. Because this person has this huge intention to make it a little bigger than what it is right now. The connection that the two of you have, they want to make it bigger. They want to make it something better. Let's see, what else do they want to say to you? I'll pick up some tarot cards from here. Again, Four of Pentacles. See, definitely this person wants to keep whatever. So at whichever level this connection is, okay, your person doesn't want to lose out on what they are getting with you. Okay, because it's very special. That's what I can see. What else do they want to say to you at this point? Ace of Cups. Wow. So look at this image. It's like this sudden flow of emotions in their heart for you. Sudden flow of emotions in their heart for you. Pretty strong. Thank you. I have the Knight of Wands here. This person has a lot of passion for you. And it's like, you're like that, I mean, I can see that they dream about having a life with you. They dream about having a setup with you. But I know that, I mean, this is what I'm channeling. They know that the circumstances around them is very tough, but they still dream, okay? They still dream, because if you see this Ten of Pentacles card, look at the picture and look at the surrounding. So it's like in their mind, this thought is always there that they want you, okay? And they see you as an opportunity. They see you as something that has been given to them from the universe. Look at this Ace of Cups. It's like love coming to them from the sky. And look at the following card. They want to like treasure it. They want to keep it with them. But I'm seeing that somewhere, yes, there is something in their life which they need to wrap up. Circumstances, issues, responsibilities, I don't know. But they still dream. They still dream of being with you. Yeah. And then I have the Knight of Cups. So yes, this person wants to come forward with something stable towards you. Okay? They want to. And then I have the Page of Pentacles. Okay? But yeah, the point is that at this phase, the stability that they can give you is the Page of Pentacles because of their situation. But it is changing. The situation is changing, as I told you. Okay? Your person is changing in general, and that's what they want to say to you. And Metamorphosis card says the same thing. Alright? Let me pick up an advice for you before we wrap up. What is the advice for 5 minutes? Round and round. Building blocks. Clean it up. Okay, so if there is a situation in your life which is revolving in circles, you have to get rid of that so that you can build blocks for your future. Now, I don't know what that situation is. Round and round and clean it up is usually about karma. And go the distance here. So, the point is that you should go the distance and clean that mess up. That is the advice to you. Okay? So that you can embrace something new in your life. Okay, pile number 3, that's what I have. You can follow me on Instagram if you like daily 3-card readings. It's Mishy Blue Tarot Official. I do daily 3-card readings over there. So if you are interested, you can check that out. Private readings are open, so you can reach out to me. Till then, take care. I shall see you soon again. Bye.